to establish the equivalence between the epsilon NFA and DFA, let's design a procedure that will convert the epsilon NFA to DFA, and it is very similar to subset construction, and we call this as modified subset construction. So the given input is epsilon NFA E with 5 tuples QE, sigma, delta E, Q naught and FE. Our goal is to construct the DFA with 5 tuples QD, epsilon, and see that the set of symbols, input symbols, doesn't change, and we have to compute the transition function QD and FD such that the language of the DFA is the language of the epsilon NFA. Now let's try to consider the set of states in the DFA QD, which is the set of subsets of QE, which is nothing but the power set of QE. Actually, power set of, it is not N, here we need to have E. As we have seen in the subset construction, QD will not be exactly equal to the power set of the QE. Instead, we will consider only the states that are reachable from the starting state, which is QD. And what is QD? QD is nothing but the epsilon closure of the starting state of the NFA, epsilon NFA. Because the epsilon NFA is starting at Q0, and this is a epsilon NFA, so it can be at Q0 or in any one of the states in epsilon closure of Q0. So that will be the starting state for the deterministic finite state automata. So the starting state is epsilon closure of Q0 in DFAD. The set of final states in the DFA will include all the subsets S in a subset of QE, that is the subsets from the power set of QE, such that at least one of the states in S will be in the final state of the epsilon NFA. So that is, S intersection FE should not be equal to null. And we define the transition delta D like this. For each set S that belongs to the set of states QD, and for each symbol A in epsilon, we consider the S to be some set P1 to Pk. Now we can find the transition for each of these states upon A and make a union of all of them. And let this set be some R1 to Rm. Now if we find the epsilon closure of each of the state and make a union, we actually get the transition in the deterministic finite state automata from the state S upon the input symbol A. We find the epsilon closure of each of the state R and make a union of all of them, and this will result in the transition function of each of the state S in the DFA and the symbol A. Let's work out an example. This is the epsilon NFA that we have constructed to accept the decimal numbers with optional sign and a decimal point and set of strings before the decimal point and after the decimal point, and any one of the set of digits can be empty. We will start with the starting state of the DFA, which is nothing but the epsilon closure of the starting state of NFA. So the epsilon closure of Q0 will be, either I can stay at Q0 using the basis, or we can use the epsilon transition and go to Q. This is a state in DFA and we label this state as A. Now we have to find the transition from A for each of the input symbols that we have in sigma. From A, if we get plus, where do we go? we have to find the epsilon closure of each of the states here. So we will get the epsilon closure of, we have to find the transition from A for the input symbol plus, so from Q naught, which is one of the states in A, if we get a plus symbol, we go to Q1. And from Q1, if we get a plus symbol, we don't have any transition. So it is Q1 union the null set. So we get Q1. And for this, we have to apply the epsilon closure. And for Q1, using the basis, we can be at Q1. And from Q1, we don't have any epsilon transition. So this will be the transition from A upon the input symbol plus. So this is a new subset of QE. So we will label this as B because this is going to serve as a new state in DFA. The other symbol minus also behaves exactly same as that of the plus symbols. So we are not going to explicitly write it, but due to the shortage of space, I have indicated only plus here. You can additionally put a bar and say minus, so that the transition from A upon the input symbol plus and minus will be similar. And the next transition will be from A upon the dot. What do we do? A is Q0 and Q1. And from Q0, if we get a dot, we don't have any transition, which is null. Union, null set union, and then we have Q1. From Q1, if we have a, if we get a dot as input, we go to Q4. So it is null set union Q4, which is Q4. And to this, we have to apply the epsilon closure. And from Q4, we don't have any epsilon transition, so using the basis we'll get only Q4. And this is a new subset, and we will mark this as a new state C. The next set of inputs are digits from 0 to 9, and all the digits are going to behave the same. And for their representation, I have simply specified 0 due to the shortage of space, but you can specify 0 to 9, all the symbols from 0 to 9. From A, if we get any of the decimal digits, from Q0, if we have a digit, we don't have any transition, so it is null set union. From Q1, if we get a digit, either I can go to Q1 or we can go to Q3. So null set union Q1, comma Q3, which is Q1, comma Q3. And to this, we have to apply the E closure. From Q1 and Q3, we don't have any transition on epsilon, so we will have Q1, Q3 as the result. And this is a new subset of QE, so, and this is going to serve as a new state in DFA. We have to repeat this procedure of finding the transition for a particular state and each of the symbols for all the new states that we have found. So we will start with B now. B upon the input symbol plus. B is Q1. From Q1, we don't have any transition on the sign, so it is null set. Epsilon closure of null set is also null set. And this is a new subset. We will label it as E. From B, if we get a decimal point, where do we go? B is Q1. So from Q1, if we get a decimal point, we go to Q4. And epsilon closure of Q4 is Q4. So this is the transition for B and dot. And this state is already existing, which is C. So we don't give a new label here. From B, if we get any of the decimal digits, B is Q1. So we go to Q1 or we go to Q3. And the epsilon closure of Q1, Q3 is Q1, Q3, which is the same set as that of D. So these are the transition from the state B in the DFA upon the different input symbols. From the state C, if we get a sign, where do we go? State C is Q4, we don't have any transition for the sign plus or minus, so it is null set. E closure of null set is null set, which is already defined as E. Similarly, from C, which is Q4, we don't have any input on the decimal point, so this is also null set. And from C, if we get any of the decimal digits 0 to 9, we go to Q2. And epsilon closure of Q2 is Q2 itself. And we get the transition from C to C upon any of the decimal digits is Q2. And this is going to be a new state because Q2 is a new subset. Let's label that with F. And we will move to the next state, which is D. From D, if we accept any of the sign plus or minus, where do we go? So Q1 and Q2 are the states in D. So from Q1, we don't have any transition for the sign, and from Q3 also we don't have any transition on the symbol. So we get null, and the epsilon closure of null set is null set. Okay, so we have the null set, which is represented as E. And from D, if we get a decimal point, okay, from Q1, if I get a decimal point, we go to Q4. And from Q3, if we get a decimal point, we go to Q2. So we get the union of Q2 and Q4. And for this, we have to apply the epsilon closure, which is same as that of Q2 and Q4, because there is no transition on epsilon from Q2 or Q4. So Q2, Q4 is a new state. So we'll label it as G. Now from D, if we get any of the decimal digits, D is Q1, Q3. So if we get a decimal digit from Q1, we go to Q1 or Q3, and the epsilon closure of Q1, Q3 is Q1, Q3. So that is the result of the transition from D upon any of the input symbols. And from Q3, we don't have any input on the decimal digits, right? And from E, if we get the sign, okay, it is, E is a null set, so we cannot accept any input from this one, okay, because we don't have any state in the ENFA in null set. So upon the any of the sign or the decimal digit or any of the digits, all of them will go to the same state. So E is going to act as the sync state now, because there is no transition going out of E. It's all self flow. And from F, when we get a plus, okay, what is F? It is Q2. From Q2, we don't have any transition on the signs plus or minus. So it is null set. Epsilon closure of null set is null set. So this is null set. Similarly, the transition upon the dot is also null set. And if we get any of the symbols, we go back to Q0, and epsilon closure of Q0 is Q0. And Q0 is already defined as F. Now consider the transition from G upon plus. So G is Q2, Q4. From Q2, we don't have any transition on sign plus or minus. And Q4 also, we don't have any transition on sign, so it is null set, and epsilon closure of null set is null set. Similarly, we don't have any transition from G upon the dot, because Q2 and Q4, we don't have any transition on dot, so it is null set. Finally, from G, if we get any of the symbols, we from Q2 we go back to Q2, from Q4 we go to Q2. The epsilon closure of Q2 will have only Q2. Q4 will not appear here. Let's now draw the DFA for the transitions that we have formed. The starting state of the DFA is state A. So A is the starting state coming from nowhere. From state A, upon plus or minus, we go to the new state B. So we go to state B upon plus or minus. From A, we go to state C for dot. So for dot, from state A, we transit to state C. From state A, if we get the symbols from 0 to 9, we go to state D. So from state A, if we get 0, 1, 2, etc. up to 9, then we go to state D. Similarly, we draw the transition for state B. For plus or minus, from state B, we go to state E. So for plus or minus, we transit from B to E. For dot, we go to Q4, which is state C. So from B, if we get a dot as input, we go to state C. And from B, if we get the decimal digits from 0 to 9, we go to state D. So from B, we go to state D for symbols 0 to 9. And for C, if we get plus or minus or dot, we go to state E. So for the three symbols, plus, minus or dot, from state C, we go to state E. And if we get the decimal digits from C as input, we go to the new state F. So we transit from C to F upon digits. And from state D, when we get plus or minus, we go to the state E. Then for dot, from state D, we go to a new state G. So from state D, if we get dot as input, we go to the new state G. And for symbols 0 to 9 from state A, we go to Q1, Q3, which is state D. So we have a self loop from D to D upon the input symbols 0 to 9. And E is a sync state. So for any symbol plus, minus, dot or any symbol from 0 to 9, we transit on the same state. So we have a self loop. Once we reach E from any other state, we will not escape from C, and for any further input, we keep on staying in the same state. From state F, for symbols plus, minus and dot, we transit to state E using this arc. And for symbols 0 to 9, we go to state Q2, which is the state F. Okay, so we have a self loop for 0 to 9 from state F. And for G, for plus, minus and dot, we go to state E. And for G, we go to upon the input symbols 0 to 9, we go to state Q2, which is nothing but your F. Okay, so we transit on 0 to 9 from G to F. Now, which are the final states? These are the transitions that we have formed. Now, which are the final states? Among the states A to G, if any of the subsets have the final states from epsilon NFA, then that state will be acting as the final state in DFA. This is the NFA we have started with, and Q2 is the final state. So in DFA, if Q2 is available in any of the states from A to G, then those states will act as the final state in the DFA. From A to G, we have to look for Q2. A does not have Q2. B does not have Q2, C don't have, D don't have, E don't have, but F has. So F will act as the final state. So this is one final state. And Q2 is available in G as well. So F and G will act as final state in our DFA, which are indicated by the double circles. Now let's find out whether this DFA is indeed accepting the language accepted by the epsilon NFA that we have started with. Suppose if we wanted to accept the string 1.2, which is a valid member of this language, we don't have any sign, because sign is optional, dot is must, and we can have the string of digits before the decimal point and after the decimal point. In this case, we start from A. We have to generate a number. So we take the path from A to D and generate 1 using this transition. And then from D, we have to generate the dot, and we will use this transition from D to G. And from G, we have to generate this 2. So we will use this transition and reach this F. So when we complete scanning the input, we are in the final state F, and it is accepted by the DFA. Let's consider another example, which is minus 0.53. So here we have used the sign. The string of digits generated in step 2 is null, and then we have decimal digits, then we have the string 53. So we start from state A. Since we have a sign, we use this transition and move to state B. From state B, we get a dot. So using this transition, we go to state C, and then we have to generate the digit. So 5 will be generated using this one, and we reach F. And 3 will be generated using this self loop, and we come back to F. So when we finish scanning the input, we are in the final state F, and this is a valid string. Now consider this example. We are trying to generate the string plus 4 point, where the string of digits generated by step 4 is null. And this is a valid string, and the machine should accept. So we start from state A, we generate the plus symbol using this transition, and we move to B. From B, we have to generate a digit. So we use this transition and generate the digit 4. If we had 4, 5 or something like that, we can generate more digits using this path. Now from D, we have a dot. So we use this transition and come to G, and G is a final state, and thus this string is a valid string. Now suppose we wanted to generate the string 1.11 point. Okay, this is an invalid string. Let's see whether when we scan this input, we land in a non-accepting state. We start from the starting state and get the first input 1. So since this is a digit, we go to D using this transition, and we have a dot. So we go to state G, and then we get another 1. So we go to this state F, which is also a final state, using this transition. And now we have another 1, which will be generated using the self loop in F, and then finally we have a dot. From F, if we get a dot, we go to state E using this transition. So after completing the input, we landed in a non-accepting state E. Thus this string is rejected, and it is not a member of the language. We have informally verified that this DFA that we have generated using modified subset construction is equivalent to the E and F A that we have started with, but formally we have to prove this.